we can start drawing the walls of the first floor. But first we'll need to make sure that we are working on the construction plane placed on the first floor. So we just run the wall command. We will select the exterior 200 mm and left alignment. We snap on this slab corner and draw the four walls. We can hit C to close the perimeter of these four walls. Now, we can see that the join between the exterior walls and the slab is visible. We can try to move the four walls 30 centimeters downwards, but we can still see these overlapping surfaces. So we'll need to move the walls a bit further away from the slab in order to hide this slab edge. We could do this by stretching the slab using its control points, but instead of that, we will use the property of alignment offset of walls. So we'll go to Properties, Walls, and we'll set the alignment offset to 1 cm, which is actually the thickness of the exterior layer of this wall, as we can see here. Now, we don't see the edge of the slab anymore, except when we zoom out due to some display issue, but this won't affect the drawings later on. In any case, we still have the walls and the slab overlapping each other. We can better see that if we see the modeling section, so we're going to add a section to the drawing with this section command. I run this section command, select one style that basically determines different ways of showing symbol of the section arrow. So I select the first style, I'm going to work from the ground floor, and just click to define the first insert point, click to define the second insert point, I do right click to go to the next step, so we'll define now the section length and viewer position, and finally a text, we can call it S1. Now, if we activate this section, we can do it from the section manager that we can open from here. We just move this next to the other panels. We can select this section and click on this button to see the model in section that will update according to this section line position. If we take a closer look now, we can see how the slab and the walls are overlapping. We can solve this situation if we extend these walls to the top surface of the slab, and we can do this with the wall extend command. So we'll switch this section off, go to Visual Objects, so we can run the wall extend command, select the four walls to extend, hit enter, select the extension direction, which would be bottom, and finally the boundary objects, which would be this slab. If we show the model in section now, we can see how only the part that is above the slab has been extended to the slab, while the other remains in the original position.